Hi everyone, welcome you all. In this video, I'm going to talk about parameters feature in TestNG. So as we know, parameterization plays a very important role in automation testing. It is required when we don't want to hard code the value in our code, and it's not good practice as well. So then parameterization comes into picture. So we will not have to hard code any value, and it will be easy to handle the new data also. So suppose any scenarios need to be run with a different set of data. So this can be achieved by parameterization. So Selenium itself is not sufficient to handle parameterization. So that's why it takes we have to take the help of TestNG framework. So TestNG provides one more good feature called parameters. So by using TestNG XML file, we can pass parameters to your test methods. Now we'll see practically how we can do this. So let's go to IntelliJ. So here I am creating a new test case. So here we already done one test case called assertion example. I'm just using the same example to pass the parameters to the test case. So I'm just copying the same. And here I will change the names called parameters example. Okay. And in this particular test case, I have created setup test and logout test and also home page. And after that, page is tier DOM class. So here, a page will be closed. So what I can do here is this particular test case, when execute this particular test case, setup method will execute. It will launch the Chrome browser and it will open the URL in the Chrome browser. And rest of the test methods will execute on the same browser. Finally, after class method will execute. So this time what I'm going to do is I will pass the driver and URL. So these two parameters from XML file to this setup method. And accordingly, the setup method will launch the browser based on the parameter and also URL. And then rest of the test methods will execute on the same browser or respective browser. So let's see how we can do that. So I'll just slightly modify the setup method and rest of the methods are exactly the same. So I'm just removing this particular part and this one. All right, so the first test is logo test. And after that, the second test will verify the home page title of the page. So fine. So now I'll just modify the setup method. Let us see how we can pass the parameters from TestNG. So what I'm going to do here is I will just setup method is take the parameter from TestNG file. So how we can possibly? So what I can do is here I will add another tag called parameters. So from TestNG, and here I will specify two parameters. So browser name and the URL. So these two parameters I will get it from TestNG XML file later. So in the curly braces, in the parameters annotation, inside this we have to use curly braces, and inside this we need to pass a parameter. So first parameter is browser, and comma second parameter is let's say URL of application. So these are the two parameters are defined here, and these two parameters are coming from TestNG XML file. So for these two parameters, I need to define two different variables, and the string variable, string, I'll say this is your browser, and the other variable is, let's say, app. So URL means that's your application. So I define one more variable called app. So whatever parameters we define here, the values of these parameters will be stored inside this variable, browser as well as app. Now inside this particular method, I will check the browser parameter. Accordingly, I will launch respective browsers. So for example, let us say this browser parameter is a Chrome. So I will write one if condition here. If the browser dot, I'll say equal ignore case, and if it is Chrome browser, just a moment, equal ignore case. Let me write one more time. Browser dot equal ignore case, and in the double quotations, suppose if it is a Chrome browser, right? So this is my condition. If it is a Chrome browser, then I will launch a Chrome browser. So I will just copy this code inside this conditional statement. So it will launch a system dot, it will set the system dot set property and location of my Chrome driver, and it will launch the browser. Accordingly, it will also launch the URL. Suppose if the browser is something else, let's say I will verify with something else. Else if, suppose the browser, else if browser dot again equals ignore case, and this time if it is a Firefox, and then I need to launch the Firefox browser. So here I will copy the code for launching my Firefox driver. So again, the same URL. So now what I have done is I'm just took this parameter from XML file. Later I will pass through XML file, browser and application. Application is nothing but a URL. And internally I'm checking whether this particular browser is Chrome, and then I launch the Chrome browser and open the URL on the Chrome. And if the browser is Firefox, then I launch the Firefox browser and then open the URL on the Firefox browser. So we need to import this Firefox from Selenium, all right? So now, so this is how we need to. So here I have opened the URL twice, so duplicated code. What I can do is I just remove from here, and because I can make that statement is common after designing the browser. So here I'll put the statement. So instead of hardcoding this URL, I will pass this parameter here, because this URL is also coming from XML file as a parameter. All right. So this is a slightly I modified the setup method. So again, I'll repeat. So setup method, we have to add @ parameters annotation, and here depends on the number of parameters passed by XML. We need to specify those parameter names, browser and URL. And accordingly, we have to specify the number of variables as a parameters. And internally, I'll verify the browser. If the browser is Chrome, and then launch the Chrome browser, or if the browser value is Firefox, and then launch the Firefox browser. And once it is decided the browser and whatever app or URL we are getting from parameter, I'm opening this URL. So this is a slight change I have done in the setup method. So now we need to pass these two parameters from XML file. Now let's see how we can pass these two parameters from XML file. Let's create an XML file for this test case. So here parameters example, for that I'm creating an XML file. So select this one, right click, create XML file. So create parameters example. So we need to create an XML file for this. So create testng XML file. All right, so okay, now it is created a new XML file. Just refresh your project, then you will see a new XML file. Synchronize your project and then you will see testng.xml, right? So let's align this code properly. Just go to code menu and here reformat code, and we need to have a test class or test name, and providing some name here. Test name is parameters test, and close this test. So inside the test, we need to add classes tag. Inside that, we need to add class tag. So this is how we need to create a XML file. So let's create a classes tag first. Classes, and inside this class tag we have to create. So class, and the class name is, so we have parameters example, that's my class name, so which is there in the default package, and close this class. So this is my testng XML file which I have created. So you can just core and reformat, everything is aligned properly, right? So now just this is a basic XML file I created. Now we need to pass the parameters to this particular test case. So inside the test case setup method, we'll take those two parameters, right? So how to pass the parameter? So currently I'm accepting two parameters. So I need to define these two parameters from XML file. So now we'll see how to pass this parameter from XML file. So we can pass parameter from XML file at class level, classes level, test level, different level, as well as suite level also. So currently I'm defining the parameters at the test level. So open the test, and here I need to add a tag called parameters parameter, and we have to give some name to this. So there was the first parameter name I specified, browser, and second parameter name is URL. So the same name you have to pass here, browser. So this is the name of the parameter. Parameter name is equal to browser, and the value also we have to define for that. So value of the browser is, let's say, Chrome, and then close this parameter, right? So this is how we need to pass a parameter. And along with this, I will also pass another parameter, that is app URL, right? So parameter name is equal to URL, and the value of the URL. So I'm passing the Orange HRM application URL. So this is the value of the URL. So now I have passed two parameters to this particular test case. So these two parameters, how to use here? We have to add another parameters tag. So parameters annotation, and we need to specify exactly the same names. browser and URL. These names exactly same as the names which I have used in the parameter tag in your XML file, and the value we are passing. So this is how we have to create an XML file. So let's execute this XML file. Now it will take a browser as a Chrome and URL is OpenHRM application. So accordingly, setup method will decide Chrome browser, and it will launch the browser, and then URL will be opened on the same browser, and rest of the test methods will be executed on the same browser. Now let us execute XML file. So run XML file. Now it is trying to launch browser. So now we can see it is launched Chrome browser because I have passed Chrome as a parameter and open the URL, and both the test method pass, logo test and home test pass. Similarly, if I pass a Firefox browser, let's say I'm passing Firefox, and this time, so in your setup method, will second condition will be matched, right? This time it should launch Firefox browser. So let me execute this again one more time. Now this time it should launch your Firefox browser. Now it is launching my Firefox. So this is my Firefox browser. Launch URL, verify the logo and title, and then it is closed. So my two test methods are passed. Suppose instead of passing this Chrome and Firefox manually, I can create two test cases. So for example, just copy this portion and make it another test, right? So let's say parameter test one, and let's change the name. So parameter test two, it should be unique name. And first time I will pass Chrome as a parameter, and second time I'll pass Firefox as a parameter. So now same test case I will execute twice by passing two different browsers. So this is one time we'll execute by using Chrome browser, and second time we'll execute by using Firefox browser. So let's execute this XML file one more time. So now both will execute now, Chrome as well as Firefox. Now I'm opening my browser. So executed. Now one is done. Now second time it is open the Firefox browser. All right. So now it is also executed and passed. So this is how we can execute the same test case with multiple parameters, and we can pass those parameters to your test case. So we can pass these parameters at test classes level, test level, and also suite level. So only thing is we have to use parameter tag here, and the test case side we have to use @ parameters annotation. So this is how we can pass the parameters to your test case. These are parameterization feature from test engine. So that's all for this video guys. So thanks for watching.